caring for the environment, being innovative, and financially benefiting in the process was just one of the messages that was being shared at the Cape Town Renewable Energy Festival in Greenpoint. The event was designed to create awareness around the benefits of energy conservation. Great ideas to support sustainable, responsible living. Invent Africa spoke to Sarah Ward, Head of Energy and Climate Change at the Cape Town Environmental Resource Management Department.
Well, I think that we are a leading city in South Africa, definitely. I mean, there are lots and lots of things that we are doing that is very innovative. We've also got a high level of commitment amongst the city politicians as well as the city officials. So, and we have quite an integrated campaign or program. I think that we're kind of out there in South Africa, and then globally as well. Strangely enough, I mean, we even can, you know, take on some of the first world cities. Amongst other cities in the south, we have a lot of kind of sister cities and relationships with cities where we do exchange. Some of the things that we do, that they do and that we do, we will have a whole lot of information exchange. One of the things that Cape Town is doing is this buildings program, which is based on guaranteed savings. Now, we're the only municipality that is doing that in South Africa, and we're one of the few municipalities globally that is doing guaranteed savings contracts for buildings.
Just on an individual level, do people resonate with the idea of saving electricity?
Well, I think that electricity costs are really hitting people in their pockets, so they definitely resonate with savings. And I think that most of the achievements that we've made as citywide achievements are due to the fact that people are taking note of the information that we're providing and understanding where they can save most. When we originally did the research to work out how to run our electricity savings campaign for the residential sector, we found that actually people really didn't know what saved most. There was a lot of misinformation going on about, oh, you must switch off your lights, switch off your lights, it'll save you money. In fact, lights don't really save you money. They're really important for reducing peaks, but in terms of saving your money, no, they're not the big money consumers. It's water heating and home heating that really knock you. So our campaign has kind of made that very clear and has moved from the kind of no cost and low cost tips through to the invest to save tips. So the no cost things are like switch down your geyser temperature. You know, people are running at 70 degrees and then wondering why that was costing them so much. So switch it down to 55, 60, and put in a low flow shower head so that you're not using so much hot water. Insulate your geyser. Those are the kind of low cost things. And now we're really moving into the invest to save because it makes sense because the tariffs have increased so much. So put in a solar water heater, put in a heat pump, put in insulation in your roof.
Is there a target that you're aiming towards, and how far are you from that?
We've had a target of 10% electricity consumption reduction off business as usual, and that was up to 2012. We exceeded that by 18%, we reached 18% electricity consumption reduction, and this is in a context of a continuing to grow economy. So it's not that the economy has just gone stagnant, and in fact the economy has continued to grow. We had a small flat period during 2009, but otherwise it's continued growing. So in fact we can really see that there is decoupling going on. There's greater energy efficiency all the time, lower energy intensity in the businesses that are in Cape Town.
And personally, what's your household like?
Well, I've always had a solar water heater. Well, since 1997 I've had solar water heaters. I've lived in three houses. They have all had solar water heaters. I would not live without one. I mean, it would just seem completely crazy. It'd be like pouring money down a black hole.
Okay. What about other initiatives? Is there any crosstalk between you and, say, 90 by 2030, organisations like that?
Yeah, we do collaborate with a lot of organisations. One of our biggest supporting organisations is Sustainable Energy Africa, because they do direct support to local authorities. So we're part of the City Energy Support Unit. And they are incredibly important to us because they really do Well, they help us raise funds, they help with a lot of technical information, and they provide this like fantastic network with other cities where we can exchange information in South Africa. So, and then we are a member of the C40. We've just become a member. The C40 invited us to come in. And so that's also another platform. And then ICLEI have been fantastic as well. So, and we, the city of Cape Town signed the Mexico City Pact in 2010. And that commits the city to reporting and to measuring, which is, I think, an important raft on which to build a lot of the work that one does. If you've got those kind of commitments, and that was signed by the deputy mayor, so it is a real commitment.